When you start with a blank canvas, it's that joy of creating. And I had a place where I could just go escape and just paint. I didn't think about cancer. It was in 2016, and I was working at MD Anderson as a volunteer coordinator. And the thoughts and the headaches that I were having started to get worse. My family members and children knew that there was something gravely wrong with me. So I went to a local emergency center. They did an MRI, and the oncologist tells me the news that I have stage 4 metastatic melanoma with brain metastases. It was a shock for everybody. What am I gonna do if I'm not here for my kids and my family and things like that? I'm gonna cry, sorry. And I said, I'm going to go to MD Anderson. Dr. Maria gave me my treatment options. She said, there's a new trial that just opened. It's a phase 2. I got a phone call and they said, you qualify for the clinical trial. And my house was just, yeah. I knew that that was going to be the best chance I was going to have to live. We saw the results with that immunotherapy. And each scan kept showing the tumors going away. The tumors going away, and then no tumors, no evidence of disease. And I just was in awe. And I felt like I had a second chance to get back to what I did before. My passion has always been to be able to make that difference against cancer. That's why I volunteered.
It is a unique moment in time for us in many ways where we're able to do the impossible.
All of us have to work together to be able to design, run, and implement successfully these clinical trials. Colleen, it's really one of the privileges of my career to see you alive and well a decade later.
I just can't begin to explain how thankful I am to be able to stand up here today, to have a voice to let you guys know clinical trials make a difference. I'm living proof. I'm standing here.